Catherine and Tom. They're the ones who are going to be making all these fearsome promises this morning in the course of this service. It's lovely to have you and your parents, and indeed, well, Amelia's great grandmother is also with us. So you're all very welcome indeed. Another thing I need to say before we start this morning is if you read the notice sheet, you will perhaps already have taken in that we're taking another step on the way towards more normal life this week, having done some tests on the air quality in here over the last couple of weeks. We discovered that with the ventilation we have in here and the size of the building, that the air quality in here, even during service, with lots of singing, is only a little bit not as good as outside. So that's a kind of proxy for not being very likely that we're going to be infected whilst in here. So as a result of that, we have taken the decision that, and this is up to you actually, and it remains with your discretion, but while you're in your places and while singing, you don't need to wear masks, okay? While you're moving around the church, we prefer you still to wear masks. Okay, so those are the new rules. Life changes all the time, but let's hope we're back to the most complete normal soon. Now, I think that's just about it. Let us take up our service sheets. Oh, by the way, everything you need is in the one service sheet today, including the music or the hymns. And I will pray the special prayer for today. God of constant mercy, who sent your Son to save us, remind us of your goodness, increase your grace within us, that our thankfulness may grow through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And our opening hymn is Child of Blessing, Child of Promise.
Then what if you were to see the Son of Man?
Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Says highly later on in John's Gospel.
For And when Jesus turns to the 12 closest disciples to see if they too want to leave, it's Peter who replies. And you can kind of hear the sigh in his reply. Well, where else can we go? You have the words of eternal life. And he goes on to affirm that Jesus is sent by God. But it's that phrase, you have the words of eternal life, which gets me and which I want to focus on this morning. You see, Jesus remains today, in many ways, a kind of disruptor. He challenges our ideas, our routines, our assumptions, our lifestyles. We think we've got it all worked out. Jesus is like, it's kind of interfering. And yet there is something about Jesus which simply cannot be denied, an intrinsic power, if you like, an authority and an authenticity. And I do think that if we started to think about at some stage, how might we defend the Christian faith to those who want to criticize it? Well, we can appeal to philosophy all we like. I mean, I like philosophy, I like theology, I like an argument, I like a debate. But the fact is we're never going to make the case for Jesus that way, in a way that is going to compel people. For me, it always comes back to this. There is something about the figure of Jesus as we meet him in the Gospels and as we meet him in our lives that we cannot deny, that has that intrinsic power. And it's to that person that I told you we're coming up in a minute. And it's to that person that this morning we're going to be entrusting Amelia. We're going to be asking Christ to look after her, to be with her, to bring her that spiritual life alongside that natural life. And it's him whose power we can't deny. And we believe that by placing Amelia in his hands, we are placing her in the safest hands possible. The one who has the words of eternal life will be looking after you, Amelia. Amen. Jesus said, let the children come to me. Do not stop them. We thank God for this child who has come to be baptized today. God, that Christ loves her and welcomes her into his church. So I ask you all, will you support this child as she begins her journey of faith? Will you help her to live and grow in God's family? We will. receive the sign of the cross. Do not be ashamed of Christ, you are his forever. Stand bravely with him against all the powers of evil, and remain faithful to Christ to the end of your life. May Almighty God deliver you from the powers of darkness and lead you in the light and obedience of Christ. Amen. Right. We need some more time. Thank you. My excuse is that this is the first baptism I've done here. We praise you, loving Father, for the gift of your Son, Jesus. He was baptized in the River Jordan, where your Spirit came upon him, and revealed him as the Son you love. He sent his followers to baptize all who turn to him. Now, Father, we ask you to bless this water, that those who are baptized in it may be cleansed in the water of life, and filled with your Spirit. May know that they are children, that they are loved as your children, safe in Christ forever. Amen. We all stand. And we're going to declare our faith in God. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? I believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amelia. Pour upon them your healing and reconciling love, and and protect their homes from all evil. Fill them with the light of your presence, and establish them in the joy of your kingdom, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Well, we all please stand. This is where we're going to welcome Amelia into the life of the church. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Amelia, by one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body. We welcome you into the fellowship of faith. We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you. And let's give her a quick welcome.
For children missing their friends at school. For those who've struggled with childcare over the summer holidays. For those who can't afford to go away this year. Lord, in your mercy. We pray that you will comfort and heal all those who are afflicted or distressed, and especially those we know and name in our hearts. May the healing power of your Holy Spirit be with them in their time of need. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We remember those who have gone before us in the peace of Christ. According to your promises, grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And as our Saviour taught us, so together we pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
stand. We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes the peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you very much. Let us offer one another a sign of peace in that restrained fashion to which we have become used. Holy You made us and the whole universe and filled your world with life. You sent your Son to live among us, Jesus, our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross. He died to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead. You send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so we join the angels to celebrate and say together, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took the bread and thanked you. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me. After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Father, as we bring this bread and wine and remember his death and resurrection, send your Holy Spirit that we who share these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood. Pour your Spirit on us that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory. For honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus, your Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Jesus Christ is holy, Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. we join together in the post-communion prayer. God of our pilgrimage, you have led us to the living water. Refresh and sustain us as we go forward on our journey. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. It says brief notices. I will try and be brief. The first thing to say is that at 12 noon, after this morning service, we have another baptism. And that is for Maver, parents, Laura and Ruben. At the time we were planning this, we didn't think we could fit everybody into the same service because of the COVID restrictions. And we probably could have, as it's turned out. So Laura and Ruben are very aware of the, you know, them being entered into the family and church side of it all. So if any of you, what I'm saying is, if any of you can stay after coffee for us to be part of that, what will be a fairly short service, it would be very much appreciated. And we're getting a nautical kind of tune coming from somewhere in the congregation. And what was the other thing? Oh yes, I remember now. The other thing I wanted to say was that next Sunday is a fifth Sunday, and that means we generally make special arrangements for covering the various things that need to be done on a fifth Sunday, and we're slightly short for next week, so we need somebody, a couple of side people and one person to help with coffee next Sunday. So if you think you could do that perhaps, would you please speak to either Ian or Jane after the service? Of course, everybody is very warmly invited to refreshments in Cornerstone after the service. That wasn't that speedy, was it? But never mind. We're now going to present a lighted candle to Amelia. So this this is a symbol as well as a souvenir in the sense of today. It's a reminder, and I hope that you will bring it back every year on the anniversary of Amelia's baptism. God has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and given us a place with the saints in light. You have received the light of Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life. Shine as a light in the world, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. And we sing our final hymn. It's a relatively short piece. We shall be singing it twice. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the light and peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.